happening here, March Madness is upon us, and with a national championship just a few weeks away, the competition is really heating up for both the men and the women. The Ryan Center at the University of Rhode Island is a host site this year for the women's tournament, and we get a chance to check out their transformation. A little over a year ago, the University of Rhode Island put in a bid to host one of the most coveted events in women's basketball. And now, their request is reality.
Everybody's talking about the NCAA Women's Regionals coming to Kingston, Rhode Island. It's a really big deal. It's a big deal for the University of Rhode Island, for the state of Rhode Island, and for New England.
The regional tournament is made up of the Sweet 16 and Elite 8. So the Ryan Center has to look the part.
We got the court in for the NCAA Women's Regionals. They bring their own court. They provide their own court, which everything on the court is painted in. There are no decals placed on the court. I think each piece, I'm not quite sure how many pieces there are 200 pounds, and we had about 20 guys in here setting up the court between yesterday and today.
But the court isn't the only transformation.
We're going to be creating rooms in the loading dock. Our football locker room is turned into a media work room, or a media interview room. The stage storage room is turned into a media work room. Every single space is tweaked in the building.
The Ryan Center is expecting well over 10,000 people for both events. One group that's excited for the event is Mrs. Colosi's sixth grade class at Greenwood Elementary.
We were asked to follow Rutgers throughout the season. We've been following them since late October. We correspond with them. We use their statistics and their any information we can find about Rutgers.
They're part of the Adopt a Team program that many elementary and middle schools in the state are participating in.
We use it in our classroom for math, language arts, social studies. We actually got to meet our stars at a Providence College game. They played late in February. We were invited to go and meet the players and the coaches afterwards. It's been an amazing experience for everybody.
If you couldn't tell from their shirts, this class is hoping for the best from the Scarlet Knights, who've been very grateful for the support.
Everyone received a t-shirt, keychains, magnets, posters, and an individual letter from either a player, a coach, or a staff member. And we treasured every item, especially an individual basketball for each student, signed by Coach Stringer, who is a Hall of Famer.
Rutgers women's basketball statistics are used to help the students learn fractions and percentages.
They get to incorporate all their scores and all their stuff that they do into work that we get to do in the classroom.
It's kind of been fun combining like their statistics and doing math problems with it.
And even create a few new fans.
I didn't really like basketball before this, so it kind of got me into it.
Well, I actually learned a lot from this because I could have cared less about basketball until we did this.
And joining us this morning is Deputy Director of Athletics at URI, Greg Burke. Good morning, Greg.
Hey, Michaela. How are you doing?
Great. You must be so excited right now. The campus must be a buzz. I mean, talk about the importance of having this, you know, regionals at in our hometown, really.
Well, it's great. Any Division I team that has women's basketball can bid on this. Mm-hmm. We did it 2 years in a row. We're the only ones in Rhode Island who ever did it. It really fulfills the kind of things Dr. Dooley, our president, has said about being an economic engine for the state. Mm-hmm. So it helps the university to have it here. Obviously, it helps the athletic department. It's great for our friends in the Ryan Center. And at the end of the day, it's great for the people of Rhode Island to have four great teams come here. There's going to be a lot of money spent in New York and Newport and Warwick. And we're thrilled to be part of that economic drive.
Definitely. And let's talk about, you know, UConn. You associate basketball with UConn, you know, nine times out of ten. The men's and women's programs have been so strong throughout the years, especially the women's team. They're in the tournament. They're visiting. So what does that mean to have these huge teams and their fan base come along with them?
Well, we don't root against anybody, but we rooted hard for UConn all year.
Yeah.
And when they won the Big East to beat Notre Dame after having lost two games to Notre Dame during the year, there was a celebration for us. UConn's going to be in a Newport area hotel. It'll be 1,000 bed nights right there. It's going to hit at a perfect time for Newport Restaurant Week. You know, UConn is the story in women's basketball of the last 20 years. And to have them come to our site, we're very close to the UConn people. We're thrilled with Coach Oriyama, and it's going to be crazy. Last night, from the time they won till we left the office around 1:45 in the morning,
wow,
we probably did $25,000 in ticket sales because
right
UConn won. So
that's fantastic.
It's fantastic.
And talk about the efforts, too, that go behind this. I mean, we got a sneak peek of the court that's there. It's not completely finished. You're still waiting on one key element.
Well, it's an underrated part of what we're waiting for. We're waiting for the basket, so.
You need that.
Right now, if it does, we're going to have an ultimate frisbee contest. But okay. We expect the baskets on Thursday. We'll have them assembled by Friday. But the effort, you know, I get to be on a show and talk to you who knows basketball and did all these pieces, but I'm really just the best spectator here. We have so many people on campus, from the president and Thorpe Bjorn, the athletic director, wanting us to do these things. We have a huge committee of people, people in our office from, oh, I'll give you a million names, Tracy Burns, who's an administrative assistant doing the hotels, Vinny Turco running the game operations, Shane doing our, Shane Donaldson doing all our PR, Adam Chem, all the people in the Ryan Center. We have
all these different elements that you probably don't think of.
Well, it's just so, there's so many logistics. We actually hired a great girl, Allison Litsky from Johnson & Wales, to be our intern to do all the details. There's so much work. The manual that we have for the games now, and we call the Bible, is this thick. We're really at the point, we're like a football team that's been in two-a-days for a year and a half.
Yep.
We've hitting each other. We want to go out and hit someone else.
All right, and lastly, what can people expect on, of course, you know, next Sunday and Tuesday going to these games?
Well, first of all, it's going to be crazy exciting. We play Sunday at 4:30 and 7 o'clock. Mm-hmm. We don't know the game order yet. We'll learn that tonight. We play Tuesday at 7 o'clock. People can access tickets, 874 Rams, or go roadie, www.goroadie.com, swing by the Ryan Center. We're probably getting, by the time I get back to the office, we'll be close to the halfway point, so we have plenty of good tickets, and it's just going to be spectacular. It's going to be one of the best women's athletic events in the history of Rhode Island.
All right, we're looking forward to it. Thank you so much for joining us. And love women's hoops. So for more information on getting in on the March Madness action at the Ryan Center, head to WPRI.com.